Good afternoon and welcome to St Giles. I'm Liam, the Vicar of St Giles, and it's a pleasure to welcome you to this, our church nativity service. I know that for many members of St Giles, many of our friends, families and neighbours, Christmas starts with the nativity, and I'm delighted that we're able to share in one again this year, albeit online. Special thanks to everybody who's worked so hard to make this possible. Thank you to our cast, our readers, our singers, our actors, our dancers, our instrument players. Thank you to Sally Poon and Ellen for arranging things, our producer and director. Thank you for Hannah for our music. Enjoy the telling of the Christmas story once again.
Thank you for joining us. Today we are going to retell a true story which changed the whole world, the birth of Jesus Christ. With an angel who is a messenger from God. His name was Gabriel. God had told him to find a young woman called Mary who lived in the town of Nazareth, keeping socially distanced at all times. Gabriel knew exactly where he would find Mary, kneeling by her bed and saying her prayers. Mary's eyes were shut tight, but suddenly it didn't seem dark anymore. She blinked and looked. The angel Gabriel was standing just 2 meters away. Mary gasped.
Don't be afraid, Mary. God has chosen you to be the mother of God's baby. You will bear a baby boy and name him Jesus.
Mary gasped again.
But I haven't married Joseph yet. We've had to cancel the wedding twice already this year with all of this pandemic business going on.
Don't worry. God, your baby is God's special baby. God will take care of all that.
Finally, after thinking about what Gabriel had said,
I will do whatever my loving Heavenly Father wants.
My soul magnifies the Lord. My soul magnifies the Lord. When Joseph had heard that Mary was pregnant, he couldn't believe it and didn't know what to do. In bed that night, Joseph tossed and turned. He was confused and didn't know what to do. Eventually, Joseph fell sound asleep and the angel spoke to him in his dream. Suddenly, he woke up. He had the answer.
I know what to do. I'll look after Mary and her special baby. I'll treat him as my own.
We are the leaders in global breaking news.
And thank you for tuning in. As your Prime Minister, I have some very important news. Today, the powers that be have said that there is to be a census. Now, I know it's not great timing with this pandemic business going on, but anyway, there you have it. So, by the royal decree, everyone must return to their hometowns to be counted and registered. Pack your hand gel and face coverings. Stay alert and stay safe, everyone. Now for today's slides.
Oh no, my hometown's Bethlehem. And the baby's coming soon. We better get a move on.
So, Mary and Joseph packed their things. They had little choice but to set off on their 70-mile journey. Mary couldn't walk that far, so she sat on a donkey and Joseph walked by her side. It took them many days.
When they arrived in Bethlehem, the town was really busy. Mary knew that they must find shelter quickly, but where? Joseph had tried all the lodging houses, but nobody could help. Then he saw the light of an inn down a dingy back alley. Maybe there would be a small room there, but the innkeeper who answered Joseph's knock shook his head and said,
"You are joking, aren't you? Have you seen Bethlehem? It's heaving. Anyway, even if I did have any space, I'd be struggling to find you any loo roll for your bathroom. It just keeps running out as soon as it comes into the shops. That's if I can get to the shops when I'm not doing the homeschooling."
Joseph thought that all was lost and started on their way. All Mary could do was pray.
"Please, God, help us."
Suddenly, the innkeeper had an idea.
"Hey, wait a minute. If you don't mind the animals, I suppose you could sleep in our stable. It's a bit whiffy, but it's warm."
And so on that night, in that stable, Mary gave birth and Jesus was born.
Inside a manger, oh what a glory of
On the hills outside Bethlehem, shepherds had been watching their sheep. Well, one of them was anyway.
What on earth are you doing? Shouldn't one of us at least be watching the sheep?
Just doing my PE with Joe as I miss this morning session. Do you want to join in?
Ooh, I'm not sure. Mind you, me and the kids have been doing a lot of home baking.
We have too. Lots of cooking cake, damn me.
Only problem is I keep eating it too. So it's probably a good idea.
Suddenly, the sky grew light and a figure appeared.
Hang on a minute. Who is coming now? I know Joe Wicks has been a superstar, but I didn't think he could fly through the air too.
Gabriel appeared out of the light. The light was so bright that the shepherds had to hide their eyes. They were so scared, but then they heard a voice saying,
"Night in Bethlehem, God's son has been born. He will be a great king. Glory to God in heaven and peace on earth to everyone."
The shepherds blinked and rubbed their eyes. It was such a wonderful sight. The whole sky had come alive and the stars shone like diamonds. It was a heavenly fireworks display. Did some actions anyway. of joy as they rushed down to greet the baby.
Well, welcome along to this very special St. Giles Vidcast interview. I'm Emma Ayres, and I'm thrilled to be joined today by the three wise men. Welcome along. It is such an honour to speak to you. And I hear there's been some very exciting news.
Yes, a star in the east. It has been growing stronger. We followed it to Jerusalem. We have been searching, praying, and waiting for the one born King of the Jews.
Amazing. That is such exciting news for all of us. And as is tradition, are you going to be taking a little gift with you?
As well as our prayers, we got on a car to the delivery slot and shall be taking gold, frankincense and myrrh to the baby.
Amazing. Well, I better let you get off and prepare for your journey. It was so lovely to meet you. Stay safe and happy travels.
So the three wise men got ready to hurry off their Zoom call, ready to make their way to Bethlehem. Before long, the three wise men, still in all their robes and finery, sent their love and prayers to Joseph, Mary, and Jesus over Zoom. They told Jesus how much they were looking forward to meeting up in person soon. They sent their gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh in the post. Even a remote celebration can still be a happy celebration. What wonderful gifts to bring to the best of all, Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
Well done, everybody. Thank you so much. I hope you have as much fun tomorrow on Christmas Day as you clearly had putting that together for us. No doubt there'll be presents to be played with, devices to spend time on, and of course, Christmas dinner to be eaten. My favourite bit of Christmas dinner is always the Yorkshire puddings. And my gran told me the secret of a great Yorkshire pudding. Wasn't the mix of flour and water and milk, wasn't the sugar or the salt, wasn't the hint of mustard. No, it was a secret ingredient, her special sauce, and that was love. My gran swore that she could tell the difference if Yorkshire puddings had been made with love or without love, and I think I can tell the difference too. We have just heard the great recipe for Christmas. All the ingredients were there. We had the wise men, we had the angels, we had the innkeeper, we had Mary and Joseph, we had the donkey, and of course we had Lord Jesus Christ, the babe in the manger. And this recipe is a love story. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son. This Christmas, let us resolve not just to read the recipe, but to taste the pudding made with love. Let's resolve not just to hear about the Lord Jesus Christ, not just to read about him, but to receive him. As it says in the gospel, to those who received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the power to become children of God. My prayer this Christmas is that we will all receive afresh the Saviour into our hearts, the light of the world who shines in the darkness, Emmanuel, God with us, Jesus who saves. Now Charlotte's going to lead us in a Christmas prayer.
Dear Lord, please help all of the people who are alone this Christmas with no one to spend this special time with. Please help us to remember the true meaning of Christmas. Thank you for the joy of the Nativity in all of our friends and family. Thank you for sending your son Jesus to take away our sins so that we will not live in sadness. We praise your holy name. Amen.
All that is left is for me and our Nativity gang to wish you a very Merry Christmas. In this Christmas season, may you have the wisdom of the wise men. May you share in the joy of the angels, and may you join in the worship with Mary. And may you know the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We go in the peace of the Prince of Peace. Have a great Christmas, everybody.